Hey guys, DJ here, and welcome back to another video. Today I will show you step by step how you can build this nice looking medieval house, which I also featured in my Lake Village speed build. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. I will upload more videos like this quite soon that you don't want to miss out on. Anyway, let's get into the video. So first off, we have the dimensions of the build. The main building is going to be 9x7 blocks with 2 3x5 block smaller structures on the sides. With that out of the way, we can start building the house by making a 4 block tall wall out of stone. After finishing the wall of the base, you can start changing some of the stone into andesite and stone bricks in order to create more detail into the wall. Punch out a few blocks in the front side and place 2 upside down stone brick stairs in the upper corners to create an entrance area. Now you will place spruce stairs, slabs and trapdoors on the sides of the wall, as you can see on the footage. To finish this layer, add a spruce trapdoor on each corner. On top, place 10 tree-high pillars out of stripped spruce logs. You will decorate these pillars by adding upside-down spruce stairs facing outwards on all sides of the pillars, except for the inside. In between and on top of these stairs, place spruce trapdoors. Then you will add another layer of spruce slabs on all of the trapdoors you just placed in between the stairs. On the edges, place spruce stairs facing inwards. This is going to be the start of the base of your roof. Make sure you copy this on the other side as well. Now place a full spruce plank block next to the recently placed stairs. Add 2 spruce trapdoors on top of each other on the outsides, another spruce slab next to them and a final trapdoor in the center. After that you will make the base of the roof. Watch carefully. On top of the base you will make a small horn. Back at the first floor again, it is time to add more detail to the pillars. You will do this by placing spruce trapdoors beneath the stairs on each side of the pillar, except for the insides. Beneath those trapdoors, you will do the same, but with spruce signs. Fill up the inside of the first floor with a mix of white concrete and diorite. You will do the same thing on the sides of the second floor. Although you will punch out a small 2 block gap for a white glass pane window. Place 2 trapdoors next to the window and add some spruce signs and buttons for more detail. Then copy this on the other side as well. Place an extra window with a small flower pot made out of 2 grass blocks surrounded with spruce trapdoors on the front side of the building. You could even add some more smaller flower pots on the sides of the building as an extra detail. In order to create an extra base, build a few pillars around the house out of stone bricks and stone brick stairs. Now it is time to connect each side of the roof using black stone bricks. Place an additional 2 black stone blocks on each corner with an extra black stone slab on the corners as well. Connect the highest points of the roof with each other in the following way. Once again, watch carefully. Place another blackstone block and blackstone slab next to the center of the roof. For the rest of the roof, you will randomly place blackstone blocks and slabs on top of the current layers to make the roof more messy. After that, it is time to add a dormer on the front side of the building. You will do this by placing 2 spruce stairs on the side of the blackstone blocks. Above the stairs, place 2 stripped spruce pillars facing outwards, with a spruce button on the endings. Add another upside down spruce stair on top of the spruce pillars, with a normal spruce stair on the sides, facing outwards. Connect the 2 points of the dormer with each other using more spruce stairs. Finally, place a spruce plank block on top. I don't know why, but I was really struggling with the horn design over here. Anyway, it all comes down to the final result you see over here. To make the dormer blend in with the rest of the roof, you will place some blackstone behind the spruce stairs. Place two spruce trapdoors stacked on top of each other in between the spruce pillars and upside down stairs, and a white concrete block and diorite stair in the middle of the dormer to finish this part of the house. On the other side of the roof, we are going to build a chimney. Build a 7 block tall brick pillar right on this spot. Consequently, you will surround the highest block with spruce trapdoors, then replace this block with a campfire. After that, we are going to give the chimney more depth by adding a 2 high pillar on the left, a 5 high in the center and a 5 high on the right, counting from the first brick block. Every pillar will have a brick stair facing outwards as the highest block. For some extra detail, you can place some brick stairs in the middle of the pillars, replace some of the bricks with granite as well as add some acacia buttons. And finally, you will surround the second highest blocks of the chimney with acacia trapdoors. To entirely finish the roof part, you could randomly place some black carpets on the blackstone, just don't overuse them. Now it is time to build the smaller structures on the sides of the house. Build a 3 high wall of stone on your designated dimensions. Mix up the stone with some andesite and stone bricks as we did earlier. Place spruce stairs, slabs and trapdoors on the sides of the wall like you see on your screen. Add 2 stone stair pillars on the sides while placing spruce trapdoors on each of the spruce slabs. Then build a roof out of blackstone bricks as you can see on the video. Once again, watch carefully. I did make some alterations later, like raising the stone brick pillar by 1 block, creating a small gap with an upside down stone brick stair, as well as placing another stone brick stair next to the main pillars. Repeat the same thing on the other side. Next to the entrance, we are going to build our last planned structure, which is going to be a small extension on the front. Place 2 stone brick walls with a dark oak fence on top of them, place a 3 long row of dark oak slabs, followed with another layer of dark oak slabs behind it, but a half a block taller. Make sure the sides of this higher layer are upside down stairs in order to create a nice connection. Finally, you could also add your own preferred details all around the house, like pathways, custom finds on the roof, hay bales, barrels, plants and farms. If you don't want an open entrance, you could also add a second wall with a spruce door, whatever you prefer. And with that, we have finished the standard medieval house. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If you did, then please consider leaving a like on the video and subscribing to the channel if you haven't yet. A tent tutorial is coming up very soon, as well as a winter themed speed build, so make sure you stay tuned for that. Anyway, have a very nice day and see you next time. Bye bye!